Hello people, welcome back to my channel. So today let's discuss regarding the impurity measures which are there in machine learning, and especially it's used in decision tree construction. So let's begin. So we have basically two types of impurity measures. That is, first we have the Gini index or the Gini index, and then we have the entropy. So basically, first of all, the impurity measure is represented with the help of the symbol, that is capital I, and in parenthesis you have a period operator, that is a dot operator. So let's start regarding the primitive type of impurity measure, which is mostly used in decision tree. That is, we have the Gini index. So Gini index is basically a CART metric, so it's mainly used in classification and regression trees in order to build the decision tree in a recursive fashion. And so there it is used as a cost function in order to evaluate the best splits whichever is in a data set. So just consider these two types of splits. So this is a two-way split and this is a multi-way split. So in this I have considered the attribute gender, and so it has two values, that is male and female, and this is a class distribution. So there are 10 instances, and in class 0 you have 6 male, and C1 you have 4 males, and in class 0 you have 4 females, and in C1 you have 6 females. Similarly, you have a car type attribute. It has 3 values, that is family, sports and luxury, and these are the class distributions. Now Gini index also determines how good a split is and how mixed the classes are in the two groups which are created by the split. Now what this means is, now you have a separate Gini index for this, whereas you have separate Gini index for this. Now this is a multi-way split. Now if I want to convert it into a two-way split, then how will I do this? So this is basically achieved like, you have car type, and so you group into two parts, that is you have family and luxury. So it's represented in this way, that is a set consisting of two groups. And then you have sports, or this can be also constructed like car type having sports and luxury, whereas family. So these are the two types of splits, or the two binary split, that is you consider with the help of this. Now in Gini index, whenever the target attribute or target variable is binary, that is yes or no, then the Gini index is given by, that is Gini index for binary values or binary variables is given by 1 minus summation t is equal to 0 to 1 pt square, where t represents the target attribute value. So this value evaluates out to be 1 minus 1 by 2, so which is 0.5. Now if the separation is good, so for a perfect separation, Gini score is equal to 0, means all the attributes, if they are well separated in a particular data set, that means the Gini score is 0. And if worst split is there, then Gini index comes out to be 50 by 50. Next, what you have is, you have categorical attributes, where you have nominal as well as ordinal attributes. So for categorical attribute values, the Gini index is given by, Gini index is 1 minus summation t is equal to 0 to k pt square, where t is a number of attributes, and so it evaluates out to be 1 minus 1 by k. And this value is the maximum value for any categorical attribute. Now if you have to calculate the minimum value, then that comes out to be 0. So this means that all records or all observations belong to same class label. So this was all about the Gini index. Now there is a one term called as misclassification rate or classification error. Misclassification error. So this is mainly associated with categorical attributes, and it's given by mathematically 1 minus max of probability of I by T. So if you have two classes, then the max out of the probability of these two classes are given. Now let me give an example in order to understand that is the misclassification error. Say there is a classroom and if there is a teacher and there are 60 students. Now there may be few students who may be sitting at the back, called as the back benches, and there may be some who may be sitting at the front. So the teacher just fires a question. So the teacher will ask the question only to those students with the assumption that the front benches knows the answer. But it's not necessary that all the front benches will know the answer. And so the question will go to the back benches and some of them may answer and some of them may no answer. So the teacher, by chance, it may also happen that she may not ask any questions to the front benches also. So that is basically a misclassification done by the teacher to the students, like who knows the answer or who doesn't know the answer. So that trait is basically called as a misclassification error. So that you mainly estimate in decision tree using the help of this mathematical estimate. Then what you have is you have the entropy. So this is the second impurity measure which is used in decision tree. So measure of impurity or the disorder or uncertainty in a bunch of examples is called as the impurity. Say for example, if I have given you a glass of water and a glass of ice cubes. So and if I ask you which has got the highest entropy, means according to this definition, if you go, that is the measure of impurity or disorder or uncertainty in a bunch of examples. So just consider this ice cubes as bunch of examples. So you will say that this ice cubes has got the highest entropy. No, it's not. So this is the entropy. Here the entropy is low, whereas here the entropy is high. So that is just another concept in thermodynamics. So that I'll not go into chemistry in detail. So this entropy basically we get from the term thermodynamics in chemistry, but in decision tree it's mainly the measure of impurity or how the decision tree draws its boundaries. So whenever in decision tree if you calculate the entropy between two attributes, you just estimate the gain. So gain is basically used to determine the goodness of a split, means how good a split is. So it's given by the impurity, that is I. Now this dot replaced with parent means impurity of the parent minus summation j runs from 1 to k. You have nvj, that is number of records in the child node, divided by the number of records in the parent node, and impurity of the child node, that is ivj. Now whenever in decision tree if you use entropy, and so here entropy of parent minus entropy of child. So whenever in decision tree if you use entropy as a impurity measure, then the gain turns out to be information gain. Fine. So till here we get to know like how the information gain is mainly calculated in decision tree. Now there is two things, like the entropy and gain index are mainly used for attributes that have large number of distinct values. So if that attribute does not have distinct values, then we need to devise some kind of ratio or something like that. So there are basically two approaches to this. So the very first approach is like to limit the test condition to binary splits only. So whenever you have an attribute test condition, you will only limit it to binary split and you don't go for any multi-way or any other splits. And second approach is to consider all the outcomes of your attribute test condition, and this approach is called as gain ratio. And so gain ratio is given by, that is information gain divided by split info. Now what is split info? Split info is given by minus summation I runs from 1 to k, that is probability of vi into log to the base 2 probability of vi. That is this estimate gives the split info, that is how the information is split throughout the data set. So that you validate. So for example, just consider all the attribute records, that for all values of I, the attributes have equal records. Now just mind you, here this k represents the number of splits, whereas here in this case k was the number of attributes. So here k has different terminology. So with this, if you go, then this evaluates, that is p of vi evaluates to 1 by k, and so this equation turns out to be log to the base 2 k. So what this basically states is that if your attribute consists of large number of splits, then you have large split info, and thereby reducing the gain information. Why? Because the gain ratio and split info are both inversely proportional. So well, that was all regarding the impurity measures in decision tree, especially in machine learning. So hope you guys enjoyed this video. If you found it educational watching this video, please do like, share, comment, and if you are new to this channel, please consider subscribing. Thank you very much for watching this video.